In Detroit, Saints beat the Lions, and you know I'm going to cue this up. Drew Brees was pushing it downfield, not way downfield, just a little bit further downfield than what we got used to. Brees' percentage of passes, 10 yards downfield, weeks 1 through 3, only 23%. Week 4, a little over half, 52%. So what happened to this Saints offense?
Well, you know, I think two things that would jump out to me. I mean, definitely Drew Brees played really good. I think was a little more aggressive with his mindset. But I think the thing that set that up was I believe the Saints played to their biggest strength on their football team, which is their O-line and their run game. And that sets up nothing better to get more explosive plays or pass plays than to have a run game and the play action passes, as you know. That's why you're shaking your head, like, because you watched the game back and you went, damn, they ran the ball and beat the crap out of the Lions up front and controlled the clock and did all that, right?
Right. Yeah, exactly. And they get under center, which you have trained me to keep a close eye on. They do a terrific job of getting them under center, sometimes even an eye backfield, but a fullback type. But there are plenty of games afterward, Chris, where the numbers are kind of misleading and they can sell an argument that you really want to have. But to your point, I mean, Drew Brees is getting the attention, and he was very, very good. But the combination of Murray and Kamara, they had 33 carries. They had 37 touches. The offense started not just by a little bit, but the offense started with those two. And that's why, I mean, to me, Brees was able to push it a little bit further downfield.
I agreed. I mean, the first drive itself, right? And I'm sorry, my computer just locked me out, so I'm putting in my password here. But the first drive itself was a 12-play drive, and I believe it was a 12-play drive. Let me get my facts straight there. Yeah,
second drive after the – I think his first pass was picked, but yeah.
You're right. You're right. It's the second drive.
Way in the rearview mirror, yeah.
13-play drive, and 10 plays were runs. So, right. And then they had two passes downfield on that drive as well. So that's unbelievable. And I think to your point, that's exactly what they did. Hey, they got an unbelievable offensive line. They got three first rounders on their O-line. Andrews Pete didn't play. I understand that. But, you know, it's really good is my point. And I think between that and just doing that, Sean Payton self-scouted thyself. And he just said, wait, what am I doing here? Michael Thomas is not in. My quarterback's 41. Do I really think the passing game is going to be what carries us all year? Or is it all these damn big guys I've drafted early on in the draft and paid a lot of money to, and this damn running back that I just paid $15 million to a year?
Right.
And I think he finally got back to his senses there and went, man, if my quarterback is struggling a little right now, there's nothing that's going to be better for him and make the game easier on him than me just running the ball. And, you know, I just think naturally, yeah, it helped him with the play action pass, got linebackers supped up. And for the most part, you saw a lot of those deep crosses and,
yes,
you know, slot seven routes, corner routes, yeah, that Brees really took advantage of.
And I really like the way he played, too. But I think people might be getting a little too carried away with, oh, Brees can throw it downfield now. He just, I mean, he went from everything 10 yards and under to really exposing that intermediate 10 to 25 yard range. It wasn't like he was making the wow big push route kind of throws. He's the singles hitter who went from hitting it between third and short to hitting line drives all over the outfield, which I'm complimenting them for, but yeah, it wasn't like this big 180 they did. They just shifted a little bit and opened up, you know, that next level of the field.
I think that's the way to put it, though. I think you're right. They don't need to be like Bobby Bombs Away and throwing 50-yard balls in the air. And he's not that. You're right. But what we just don't want to see is a bunch of 5- and 6-yard throws right over the middle. If they just do like to what you're saying, have a number of 15- and 20-yard pass attempts and completions and concepts that way, I think with that, between the formula of running the ball – you know, it's going to make everything simpler for Drew Brees to see downfield. And, you know, I think really ultimately it's going to make them a more aggressive football team and a better football team instead of trying to look for 7 million different ways to throw the ball 4 yards. You know, you can live dangerously that way. One tip ball, you know, a few incompletions and all of a sudden it's three and outs, and all of a sudden you're losing a football game. to where I think really they're playing to the strength of their football team at this point of Drew Brees' career and where they are with this team to get underneath the center. Like you said, we saw a lot of, you know, tailback, fullback, tight end, two receivers, like 21 personnel looks, to where they just played smash mouth football and said, nah, I'm smart coach, I'll have some good run plays, and we're just better than you up front, and I'm going to beat you that way and force you to stop that, and then you'll see Emmanuel Sanders going behind you and all that stuff. And I think that's really what stood out to me more than anything.
I want to get your response to this question, Chris, from at jsalowich25. He says, was Drew Brees' ability to throw downfield a sign that he still has the goods when he needs it, or is it just confirmation that Matt Patricia and the Lions are incompetent on defense?
Well, it's not the best defense in the world, but I think it's more, I would say, the Drew Brees thing. You know, I didn't look at Drew Brees' arm through the first 3 weeks and just go, oh my gosh, it's so much worse than last year. Like, he can't do it. I just felt like there was a reluctance to do it. That was what, kind of what I had said on our Monday podcast. Like, too many plays where he's setting up to throw that deep cross and you're just like, man, throw it. Why didn't he throw it? And he just, for whatever reason, didn't pull the trigger or whatever it was. But I didn't see any of that hesitation in this game. And, you know, again, like we said, it doesn't need to be like way down the field. They just need a little bit to help out their run game, their screens, and some of those short passes will all open up if they can just continue to kind of hit those 15 to 20 yard passes.
Yeah, 13 yards for completion for Drew, easily the best he's had this season and above the average he's had in recent seasons.
I want to say one more thing, too, about it, Paul, I thought, because you kind of brought it up, and I wrote this in my notes, but I felt like there was a little bit of a Brady and Tampa Bay feel to what they did with Drew Brees. It's something I've been saying with Drew Brees, or, you know, Brady and Tampa the last few weeks, but the one thing I noticed was, you know, when they got into the spread, right? All right, shotgun spread, it's going to be, okay, get the ball out of your hands quick, quick, quick. But then when they got into some of those traditional fullback, running back, high formation looks, you know, that's when they went to play action, max protect, let Drew feel comfortable so then maybe he can feel comfortable and confident in throwing that ball down the field and things like that. And I think that's always a really good way to kind of get a quarterback who may be struggling with throwing the ball downfield to get him to feel a little bit better about doing it. Hey, protect him up, you know, make the formation simple so it's just really clear to him down the field. It's an easy read. And then you build on it from there. And that, I think, was something that kind of jumped out to me about the game.
Did you see that fourth and short early when they used Kamara? On the wheel routes. I mean, that was a terrific call and a wonderful throw.
A wonderful throw, right. And that's, you know, again, that was probably, what, a 15, 18-yard throw. But they do that, maybe not even, maybe 12. I don't even know what it is. But, brilliant play design once again. And, yes, you see that. Like, it wasn't like he was wide, wide open. No. You know? So, but Brees dropped back with conviction and made the decision and just let it go. And if we see more of that, you know, this Saints offense will get rolling and they'll be one of the better teams in all of football.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.